Okay, if you have verified Niladri, I said raise your hand only when you feel talking is the only way to communicate. Otherwise, you can send a chat or you can send it in Q&A. Okay, kindly follow that. Set up your password, which will be here in your account, not in my account, because I am already having this account there. So it goes to verify email, then come back, go click on next. Then this personal information, it will ask you some very basic information, first name, last name, country name, those kind of things. And then click on create account. That should be working in your account, it should be working. Have you been able to log in? Those who have not been able to set up the account, we will wait for a while, but then I'll ask you to raise your hand if you have been able to set up the account and log into it. Okay, out of 42,
Dr. Tyagi,
kindly raise your hand once you have set up your account. Yes, yeah, ma'am.
I think we can move forward because maybe some of them you have one device and then they are working on some, maybe they are not working on that device. So maybe we can move on to the learning part of it.
Okay, that also we will come.
Yeah, so that's what it
But
is. They
you
were
know,
just saying.
ma'am, that learning part will not work if they don't have a functional, they say they don't have an account. We are just listening to it will not help. So
I know
if you permit, I'll wait for say a minute or so, and in case they have a problem, I'll handle it right now. If you have been able to set up your account,
So one of them, she has written that there is a network issue also, so they have to work on two devices. So
okay.
maybe we can go.
Those who have a problem and they can't do it, we won't wait for them. But those who are here to learn and want to say, they will have to work along.
Okay, Monica Nagpal has said she has created her account, so we are
Okay,
ready with one
four
person.
people have raised their hands. So me, four
Yes.
people have opened their accounts and logged into it. Now, others, if they are finding it problem, kindly do let me know right now. I'll handle it. Live, I'll handle it. So this is what comes, email. Then it goes to first name, last name, country name, set up some password. There are a few compulsions. Then it opens up this, which you can read whenever you have time. And then you click on acknowledgement, proceed. That's it. Once you click on proceed, you are, I will, okay. And once you can log out, top right corner, you can log out. If you come back, you will be here. Now here I am putting in my, this is the account which is fresh. It doesn't have any chatbot in it. I'll make one with you. Okay, so if you have accepted all those terms and conditions, this is where you end up. It will bring you here, and your screen will look exactly the way my screen is looking. There is a button behind in this part. So if you are having videos in this part, you can drag those videos little bit down. On the top right corner, there is a button called Create Resource. I will suggest that you drag the videos down till the time it becomes a band in the lower part of your screen. Because if you have videos on this part, you will not be able to see this Create Resource. For the first time, you can use even this one, Create a Resource. But next time, this will not be there. All the resources which you are having will be displayed here. Okay, so now anyone who is facing a problem, who wants to log in, wants to have a hands-on experience, wants to have an account, want to work on it live with me and is not able to do it, I like to help you out. Can I have a quick feedback? Like out of 35, how many of you, will you please raise your hands once again? Click on participants in the lower part of the screen. If you bring your mouse down, there's participants. And below that, you have a option for raising your hand. Only three people have, four, five, out, seven. Out of 35, seven people are ready. That means 28 people are going to, eight are ready. Does that mean that 29 are going to only listen? In that case, I think I did a good thing in setting up that course, because at least whatever I'm teaching you will be there in some form or the other with you. So eight people are ready to move ahead. No one is saying that they are facing problem in opening their accounts. So I understand that eight people want to learn along, and others will like to see what can be done, and then might be later on they will try it out. So okay, ma'am, should we proceed ahead now?
Yes, Dr. Tyagi, I think we should
okay.
move ahead.
Okay, now you can put your hands down. Okay, so now we are on dashboard, and on this side there is a blue button which says create resource. Now resources, Watson Assistant, IBM Watson Assistant is one resource. Let me show you other resources also which are there. Lot of resources which IBM offers and offers for free. We will not get distracted with them today, but then at least you know what is called a resource. So I'm clicking on create resource. You can click on this catalog also. And in the left panel, in the catalog, they are showing certain things which are featured products. But then if you want to see the full thing, you can go to services, you can go to software section, consulting section, you can go to any. And if you feel 172 is a very big number, how do I know which service do I want? Then you click on AI and machine learning, artificial intelligence, machine learning. Still you see there are 18 items. And you will be pleasantly surprised, many of them say free. Free. This is what we are going to use, Watson Assistant. You have Watson Studio free, Annotator, Knowledge Catalog, Discovery. Discovery is one of the skill which it will suggest you during the chatbot, that do you want to add it? Then you have language translators, machine learning, natural language classifier, natural language understanding, personality insights. Text to speech, speech to text, tone analyzer. You can have all these things, and if you see the word there, free, free, free. Lot of things which are free. Voice agent with Watson, visual recognition. So these 18 services, these 18 are free, and they are just in this AI and machine learning part. You can explore other things also. So I am clicking on Watson Assistant. This is what we are going to learn. And when you click on it, it creates an instance of Watson Assistant for you. Now it will offer you free few plans. Now the first plan is light and free. My suggestion is go by the default plan. All these things that you see, now, there's London, Sydney, Frankfurt. If you like some city better, you can choose whichever you want. General principle is that choose a server which is nearest to your place. Now I don't know whether London is nearer or Sydney is nearer or Frankfurt is nearer. So I'll keep the default value, whichever it is suggesting. The light plan is free, and there is a plus trial for 30 days. If you want to really see the power of chatbot, for 30 days, you can check it free. And then there are those other plans. Plus plan is there, premium plan is there. For the time being, I suggest that you go by the default plan. Click on this create. Now, if you are having videos in the right panel, this button would be hidden. On the right, there is a blue button called create. Kindly click on that create. And in your account, in your IBM account, IBM has created an instance of Watson Assistant. Means it has given you the space to create your chatbot. So this is what it is. In the right, it shows the plan and it is giving you a link to upgrade the plan. You need not upgrade it. In the left panel, you have few things that you can explore later on. Right now, I won't take you to that place. Now, there are certain API keys, URL, etc. But then there are other places from where you can get these things. So no need to get distracted. Click on this launch Watson Assistant. Now, a word of caution. This is the place where many people face problem. Many of them say the link does not work. I'll tell you why. Some people get very fascinated by chatbot, but then their children also get fascinated with the chatbot. And in a single laptop, there are many login IDs, many Gmail IDs which have logged into IBM account, and that's why the problem comes. If you face a problem, now see, right now you won't because I'm working with that solution here. If you face a problem, it will say it was not able to serve this request like this thing. The way out is press Control Shift N. It will start browser, this window called? I always forget this word. Incognito mode. So it will open up an incognito window where, you know, what happens is basically what you are supposed to do is shut down your laptop and restart, and you won't have any problem. But another solution is press Control Shift and N. It will start an incognito window which does not remember the cookies which were stored in your browser, and it will work. So right now, because I'm working in incognito window, it will not give an error. It will work. It takes a little bit of time. Okay. Few things with their own experience. This is a screen that you will be getting. Even I'm getting the same screen because there is no chatbot in this account. So this, my first skill, it has made by default one skill and one assistant. I'll tell you later how to say, we'll deal with it. Click over this. If you bring your mouse this side, the side panel opens up. Bring your mouse this side, the side panel opens up. And it shows you two things, skills and assistant. Just a word, what these are. Skill is your chatbot. Whatever you have made, that's what your chatbot is. This is your skill. Now, what is an assistant? When you put your chatbot on the website, it might be having other skills also. For example, discovery that we were seeing earlier, search skills, they also might be added to your chatbot. All those skills are put in a packet, in a container, which is called assistant. So assistant is basically your end product when you are putting it on the website. Skill, each skill is one chatbot of yours, say practically speaking. So in your free account, you can have 5 skills. You can write 5 skills in your free account, and which is more than enough, good enough. Now click on skills. And it shows you this window. It says create skill, but it has already created one skill, which is called my first skill. You can rename it. Let me bring it a little bit up. Now I have to move my own videos. My videos are coming in the down part. Okay, you can rename this skill, or you can delete it altogether. Doesn't matter, because we are going to start a fresh skill. Doesn't matter, you can delete it. Okay, it says Okay. It says that there is an assistant also, and that assistant is already having this skill, so you can't delete it. Doesn't matter. Let me create a new skill, and then I'll tell you how to delete this one later on. Create a skill, and it asks you which skill. Search skill, which we are talking about earlier, discovery, and dialogue skill. Right now, we are going to talk about dialogue skill. Click on it, and click next. Dialogue skill, create a skill, dialogue skill, click on next. Now give it some name. So what I'll do is my Semka chatbot. This is the name, and trying chatbot at Semka. The description is optional, doesn't matter. Later on, you can explore the languages in which all this material is available. And click on create dialogue skill. In the panel, I see some of you are busy following instructions. Okay, create dialogue skill. Now, this is a part. Say now we are actually going to work on making a chatbot. So what I suggest is, if you either go, you will have to go through the recording or go through that course which I suggested you at anytimeteacher.com, or I can give you a minute to log out. In the top right corner, you have this icon, log out, log in again, and come up to this position. Because the confusing part where all that options in IBM, they confuse people, it ends here. Now we are going to work on actual chatbot. So what I'll do is quickly, you have the time to do it yourself. Quickly, what I'll do is I'll log out. This part, I'll have to remove the screen share first, because that has gone behind it. Okay, let me share the screen once again now. Okay, so I'm back to this wallet screen. There would be two tabs. Clicking on this top right, log out. And quickly I will log in and follow the whole procedure once again. Okay, return to home page, or you can start with the same thing, cloud.ibm.com. IBM ID. Usual logins. Brings you to the dashboard. Okay. This time there will be a resource showing. See, now this time we have some resources showing that you have chosen some services. I'm bringing you here because this is the part which I have seen people get most confused. So in the resources, it will show you one services here, that you have one Watson Assistant -LA, which you can change the name from here. You can change the name. You can even delete it on the right side. If you click on it, so you see the first time login, and when you log out and then you come back, the environment is not exactly the same. But then now onwards, it is the same. Launch Watson Assistant. In another tab, it will bring you. Okay, so two participants have raised their hands. Mathura Mohan Roy, and Ram Thakur sir. So Ram Thakur sir, will you okay, let's start from Ram Thakur sir. Yes sir. Kindly unmute yourself. I think he raised the hand by mistake. Okay, Mathura Mohan Roy sahab.
Maybe they have created the account and they are with you at that moment.
Okay. Because I felt that someone has raised the hand up now. No problem. Mathura Mohan Roy sahab has raised the hand up even now. Okay, so again, I'll continue. Kindly use Q&A because that's much easier to handle. Okay, so if I go to skill, now this time it is showing two skills, my Semka chatbot and my first skill. I'll show you how to delete it. Don't worry about that part. Now we click on it and we develop our chatbot. And let me take a quick feedback, a minute feedback, that have you been able to reach up to this point or not? Because this is the confusing part. The remaining part is actually the interesting part. So quickly, you can either write it in the chat box. Kindly avoid raising hand because you know the procedure is very long. We have to first unmute you, then ask you what you want to say. So better use either Q&A or use the chat box. Okay, Hemen Sharma sahab. Sir, after dashboard, I'm confused. Should I create one? Okay. What I'll do is I'll show you that after dashboard wala, I'll show you live.
Okay, Dr. Sunit, he has said he has created account. Gurpreet, she has said that she has already done. So Raghven said that he lost power in between, but he has created the account.
Okay, no problem. What I'll do is I'll answer that question because as I said, that's my experience. That is that we have taken a lot of time, but then that is a confusing part where people get lost and they don't know the chatbot part was very simple and easy, but this part actually confuses. So let me answer that query which was asked. So I'll log out and take you back to log out. And take you back to that IBM cloud, cloud.ibm. Login fresh. And you are on dashboard. So your answer, sir. On the dashboard, except for the first time when you log in, all the resources that you bought, you say bought means bought for free, they will be showing here. Now it says one resource have been incorporated, or say you have purchased it for free, one resource. Where is it? It is in the services. If you click on it, see, please let me show you once again. If you go to create resource on the top right, it will take you to the catalog. And in the catalog, you can hunt for Watson Assistant. But that we have done once. We have already got Watson Assistant in our account. So if you click on services, because now you have to use the same instance in the second next time login. All these resource lists that you have got are here. Now there is only one. Everything else is showing 0000. In services, there is a Watson Assistant that you have got. If this name confuses you, then let me change it. Say edit name. Instead of Watson Assistant LA, let me say this is Semka Watson Assistant and save. You will see in the services, it will show one instance of Watson Assistant, Semka Watson Assistant. Click on it. It takes you to this page where you have to just do one thing, launch Watson Assistant. I said everything else we will be able to find at other places. launch Watson Assistant and you are in that place where you will be actually working on the chatbot. Have I answered your question? Now here, click, if you bring the mouse to the left, it shows you assistants and skills. We will start with the skills and we will handle the assistant later on. And here we have one skill named My Samka Chatbot, another skill, My First Skill. We can have 5 skills in the free account. So let me click on this My Samka Chatbot. And these are the things that this chatbot has. Basically, we will be working with intents, entities, dialogues, and options. These are the 4 things that we will be primarily working on. My way of doing it is little different than what you see on many courses on the internet. And that is, believe me, this is the way I have found out to be most simple, easy to understand way. What we do is we start with the dialogue. We don't start with intent and entity. We start with the dialogue because the dialogue is what what a chatbot is. Now I strongly suggest, because I will need the right side, if you have videos in your right panel, either kindly close them or drag them down, because now I will need the right panel. The chatbot will be tried out in the right panel. So I am reducing my own video so that they don't hinder me anywhere. And this is the page. You need to see the whole page. And if you are not able to see the whole page, by chance you don't know how to minimize a video, do let me know. I will minimize this window itself, but you know that will take up the space. I can reduce this window to the left part so that in your just let me show you what I mean. See, if I reduce it like this, this part of the window, of this window, is where we will be trying out our chatbot. So I need this part. So if you have it full size, it might be coming behind your videos in Zoom. So pull it down or reduce that video part. Okay, now click on dialogue first. Repeating, this is not the usual way. Usually they teach intent first, entity first, dialogue. I am teaching you dialogue first, and then what we will do is we will work on intents and check our dialogue, then work on entity, check our dialogue. So basically it is the dialogue which works. So click on dialogue and you will see this is already there. This is what is already there. There is a welcome node. These are called nodes. There is a welcome node and there is an anything else node. I'll take a minute to explain to you what is it. Welcome node is whenever the chatbot is started or reset, the first node it sees is the welcome node. So whatever you want to say when the chatbot starts should be placed here. Now let's change it. Whatever is the default, we will change it now. Now, if you click on this node, this panel opens up. And when you bring your mouse here, it takes the whole space, whatever space it needs. So this node is named welcome. Whatever you write here, it doesn't matter. It's internal name. Welcome. If assistant recognizes welcome, which means the chatbot has started or has been reset. In that case, it will, this is what it will see. Welcome. Then it's all, you know, child's play now. Then assistant responds with text, or you can click on that drop down menu, text or options. You can give 3, 4, 5 options that what do you want to do today, and give them 3, 4, 5 options, or a pause or an image. I'll be using image, don't worry about it. Right now, let me keep it as a text. Okay. This is where it opens up. Assistant recognizes welcome. Assistant responds with the text. And this is what it will ask. Hello, how can I help you? Now, let's change it. Otherwise, we will never be able to see how it works. Instead of it, say, hello, I am Rajiv. What can I do for you? And then you come down, bring further down, and it says you can add more responses. I don't want to do that. And then assistant should, and I have selected here, wait for reply. It can wait for reply or it can jump to somewhere. That I'll teach you later on. It can wait for reply. So let's wait for the reply and let's try it out. Top right corner here, you will see a button called try it, which is white. When you bring your mouse, it becomes blue. Click on that. And in the right side, a chatbot will open up and the first line it will say is, hello, I'm Rajiv. What can I do for you? Are you able to see it? If you are making...
Yes, Dr. Rajiv, we are able to see. Yes.
Yeah, if Raghavendra Rao, sir, I said raising hand should be used only when you have to speak. Otherwise, kindly use Q&A. Sir, I'm trying from mobile. Sir, my service is also showing zero. Because you have not got your services, Himen Sharma, sir. You have to use a laptop or computer. This is a big environment. It won't work from the mobile. You will not be able to work on the mobile. And your services are showing zero because you have not taken the Watson Assistant service. And I think you go through the course that I have put up there. In the next session, you will be able to work along with me. Okay, so right side, there is a black panel. And the first thing it says is, hello, I'm Rajiv, what can I do for you? You write whatever you want to write and you will see, it gives you the response that I haven't understood or something like that it will say. Say, I am here to learn. You say whatever you want to say. And it says, I didn't understand, you can try rephrasing. Why did it do that? Okay, one more Q&A. Yes, you are right, sir. I have got along to the dashboard page, but I should open in lab. Yes, please. Yes, you should. Hemen, sir, yes. Preeti, ma'am, can we use IBM Cloud in Windows 7 or Windows 10 required? No, Windows is not an issue. Windows is not an issue. You will be working on the IBM server. So your operating system doesn't matter. Okay, those questions I have answered. Okay. Now, how is it that it is giving this answer that I didn't understand? You can try rephrasing. Click on this thing. You can close that. Good enough. Close that. Come to this anything else. See, from welcome, it does only this part. What part? Again, I'm showing you. Assistant recognizes welcome. It says, hello, I'm Rajiv. What can I do for you? Then there is nothing. And then it says the assistant should wait for reply. So it waited for my reply. I wrote there, I'm here to learn. But then do what? It goes to anything else. And what does anything else has? See this thing, anything else? Anything else? If assistant recognizes this node, anything else means it has reached this node, then assistant responds with text. And it said three out of the three, it has three answers. You can add more, enter response variations. You can add more, but I'll remove it. For the time being, I'll remove it. I'll remove the first one. Use this box. I'll remove the third one. I didn't get, I'll keep only one. Can you reword your statement? I'm not understanding. And then what I'm doing is I'm adding a response type. Let's see. Adding a response type. And it says what response type. Oh, just a second. I clicked it twice. No problem now. Okay. So assistant responds with text. It will say this. Can you reword your statement? And then it also gives one image. Also gives one image. Now, let me get the image on your, say, free flower pics. And say, any picture, whichever they allow. Okay. Okay. So copy image address, paste it here from the net. Okay, and then click on try it. Now this time see the fun. Before we try it out, let me repeat. It will see welcome, where it will say only one line, hello, I'm Raji, what can I do for you? And then whatever you say, it will take you to anything else where it will say one line, I didn't understand, you can try rephrasing, and there are flowers. Let us check. Click on clear. I'm repeating, kindly click on clear, otherwise your old version is running on it. Click on clear, it will start the chatbot fresh. Hello, I'm Raji, what can I do for you? And I'm again saying the same thing. You can press the upper arrow key. Out of those four, na, right, left, top, down. You can press that upper arrow key and the last question will come up. I am here to learn. Now see what it says. Can you reword your statement? I am not understanding. And then it gives you the flowers, which means I am just fooling around. Now you say whatever you want to say. Ki, what's the time? Whatever you say. It says, can you reword your statement? I'm not understanding and I'm fooling around with you. Or you say, who are you? Whatever you say, it has only one answer. Can you reword your statement? I'm not understanding, and then it fools you around. Now we have to teach it that this is not the only answer. This answer you should give when you are not able to understand. So we are going to develop the understanding of this chatbot, and that brings us to intents and entities. Have you understood it so far? Close this window. You can clear it to start a new chat, start it fresh. That's where we have reached now. So in case in this session, our chatbot is not able to understand what the person is talking about, it will come to anything else where it will say only these lines. This is what it knows to say. Can you reword your statement? I'm not understanding. And then it will present the person with these flowers, which means the chatbot has not been able to understand what the person is talking about. But then I showed you, even Alexa can get into a situation. Alexa, stop. I'm sorry I took your name. Immediately it became active. Even that is not able to answer all the queries. That's okay. That's perfectly okay. So let's teach our chatbot some intelligence. So in the course that we were following, you will find in this course, this I have taught you, getting an IBM ID. Now setting up your Watson resources, I have made a small video in case those who are not able to make the chatbot right now. There is a small video here where I have explained all these steps. This, all these things we have done. This part we have done. Now in this skills, we are on this part. This we have clicked. All these things we have seen. In the skill, create skill, or you can rename the skill. In create skill, dialogue skill, click on next. We named it something, created a dialogue skill. And then we are basically here now to use these intent entities dialogues. And moving on to the next topic, say skills, these four types I said mainly. And the one which we were talking about now was this dumb conversation. This conversation that we were talking about now, dumb conversation means whatever you say, it will answer only with whatever is there in the anything else. It doesn't have much intelligence in it. So quickly, let me show you what we have done so far. Once again, you will have to remove the videos from your right panel. At least drag them and bring it to the left. Okay, so what all you can do? See, right, so far we haven't learned anything else. Say welcome or anything else. Say whenever it recognizes. Assistant can respond with one of the four ways. say we have used two of them, text and one picture, and in the text you can have more than one text. See what happens is, if every time it says, "Hello, I am Rajiv. How can I help you?" "Hello, I am Rajiv. How can I help you?" "Hello, I am Rajiv. How can I help you?" You will say, "Yaar, machine ho kya? Machine ki tarah kyun baat kar rahe ho?" So it means people expect chatbot to have some kind of that human factor. So say, "I have not understood what you are saying. Please rephrase it." "I have not understood what you are saying. Please rephrase." "I have not understood." Instead of that, you can say, "I am sorry. Will you please repeat?" Or kindly rephrase what you said. "I have not. I could not understand. Can you say it again?" If you have different responses every time, the person gets a feeling that they are talking to a real human being, and that's the beauty of the chatbot. That when it responds, it looks like as if some human being is talking to them. So what you can do is to bring that element. You can add variation to the text. For example, "Can you reword your statement? I am not understanding." I'll add some more. "I am sorry. Will you please repeat?" Enter. Then some more. "Kindly say it in different words for me to understand." Enter. And then out of these two, random and multi-line, you can pick up random. That will give you also fun, because you don't know which of these three it will choose, but it will keep on choosing different response every time, and it will give you a sense that your chatbot is a, you know, real thing is there behind it. So I'm choosing random. You can choose sequential. Sequential means the first time it comes here, it will give you this response. Second time, if you reach here, it will say this response. Third time, it will give you this response. But I have chosen random, just to have some little bit more fun. Okay, so this is where we have reached so far, that welcome and anything else. Now we want to add some intelligence to it, and that's bring us to intent. Now, what is intent? I'll give you my own example. When a person enters my office to meet me, I have no idea what is this person, who is this person, what is this person has, what this person has come here for, whether this person is a parent, is this person a tour operator, is this person a seller. I have no idea. Now, if the person uses the word tour, I have it in my, immediately I understand either this person is a tour operator who is here to offer some tours, or he is one of our tour operators and has come for some payment, or the payment parent has come to talk about a tour, or the parent has come to pay for a tour or to complain about a tour, but one word has set me in one particular direction. Now suppose a person says, "My child and a tour." Now I have got an idea, this person's child, you start getting an idea. The child went on a tour, might be some issue. The child want to go on a tour, want to ask about the tour, or want to pay for the tour. But then out of infinite possibilities, that's how human mind works. Right? That from keywords, you try to catch the intention of the person who has come to talk to you. Exactly the same thing is what intent is. Okay, so again, I'm going to screen share. So we go to this intent part now. Intent. There is no intent here. So I create an intent. And first intent I'm creating is directions. Now don't remove this hash. Initially it was not there, but then IBM realized that if every time every intent should have hash in front of it, why not put the hash in the code itself? So don't remove that hash. Let me delete it. Let me remove it. Now see, do you see this? This hash remains there. You can't delete it, because all intents, their name should start with a hash. So this hash will be there. So say directions. Create an intent. So an intent with the name of directions has come to guide people to our place. Just a description so that later on, if we have too many intents, we are able to know which intent, what it does. Now, give it five examples. Give it five examples that this is what this intent that we want to handle might be asked in these kind of words. Give it five examples. Okay, it says add at least five unique examples to help Watson understand. So I'm adding those five examples. Say, where are you? Okay, press enter. It will go wherever it has to go. What is your location? What is your address? And press enter, right? Enter. Okay. Please share location. How can I reach you? Okay. Now, if you bring it down, you will see these examples have been added here down. You know, where are you? What is your location? What is your address? Please share location. How can I reach you? Now, on the top right, now you have to train Watson that this is on the top right. Go to try it, and then for a while you will see something happening there. Kindly look at the right black panel which will open up. Try it. Do you see that violet colored putty? If you are able to see, tell me what is written there.
Watson is training.
So you are doing it along with me. Thank you so much. It says Watson is training. It won't take long to train. It will hardly take few seconds, or even if you have a very, very slow type of thing, but it won't take long. And it will learn these five. And now you will see the effect of it. Wait for a few seconds. Okay, done. That's all it takes time to. Now you click on clear, because there is a previous chat here. Click on clear so the chatbot starts fresh. Hello, I'm Rajiv. What can I do for you? Now, let's say, let's ask a question in a way that was not given in the training examples. Okay, so say, can you please tell where is your institute located? Now, you know very well, this is, yeah, I can show you even now, none of these five examples is what I'm asking now. But then you see how it works. There won't be fireworks. There is still that inbuilt stupidity in it, because the dialogue, it doesn't know how to respond. But then see the difference that happens. See what I have entered. Right? Can you please tell me, I'll have to bring it up. I said, this. Can you please tell where is your institute located? And now there is an additional thing here, hash directions. The chatbot, even though this is not even near to the examples that you gave it, but still it has been able to catch one thing, that your intention is to ask for directions. But then after catching this thing, intent directions, it says the same thing again. Can you reword your statement? I am not understanding, and gives you the flower. Now these flowers are taking up a lot of my space. So what I'll do is I'll remove these flowers. Lot of fooling around, it will keep on doing otherwise. Anything else? And I will remove response with the text and response with the image. I am deleting this one. Okay, now once again I clear it and I ask the previous question, and you can see it has been able to catch that I am looking for directions, but it still doesn't know how to answer. So let us teach it how to answer. If it has been able to catch that the intention is, see, for example, there was a really, say, duffer person, anyone who comes to the counter, he says the one thing: can you please rephrase? Can you please rephrase? Can you please rephrase? Now that person has somehow got the intelligence that when that person speaks, the person, the counter person, the person who is handling it, say receptionist, knows that this person is asking for directions, but he still responds with, can you please rephrase it? I'm not able to understand. So let us teach, if you have been able to catch the intention, how to answer back. So close this window, go to your dialogues, click on welcome, and then say add node. We will make a node to handle all the all this extra knowledge that this chatbot has. Add a node. So a node has been added in between. Write a name. Even if you don't write a name, doesn't matter, but later on when you have a lot of nodes, you will get confused. So I'll naming this node handling directions. Okay, handling direction. If assistant recognizes, click on it. The moment you click on it, it will say what recognizes what. You say the intent, click on intent, and you will see how much is already done there. Very little that you have to do. So intent. The moment you say intent, it says there is only one intent, which is directions. So you click on it. If assistant recognizes, and now you don't need to code, it has helped you to code. If assistant recognizes hash directions, this is actually the name of our intent, but then it guided you to do that. You don't have to remember anything. Then assistant responds with, and this time let me do something. Okay. I will, or say, I can guide you to my place. This time, if it catches intention, then it will not respond with, will you please rephrase? Will you please rephrase? Can you rephrase? Can you rephrase? It won't say that. And it will respond with a different way. Now, let's try it out. Let's try it. So let me remove this previous one. Hello, I'm Raji. What can I do for you? Because it doesn't know anything else. It has only one welcome. We'll change that also. Now, this time, if you say, can you please tell me where is your institute located? Do you see the change? Because it caught your intent, now the answer is different. Okay, I can guide you to my place. Now you ask something else. Can you teach me physics? And see what it does. Can you reword your statement? I'm not understanding it. But then now your choice. You try out, you say which way will you like me to check this intent. You tell me, say, suggest a word. Or okay, let me ask another thing. Which courses do you offer? Good thing. We can learn this thing here. It caught a wrong intent. Which courses do you offer? And it says directions intent. You click on it. Okay. No, let the second intent come, and then we will handle this thing then at that time. Okay. Oh, I pressed the wrong button. It went into training, and now it will take that as direction. I'll have to correct it later on. Okay, that I'll correct, because we were having just one intent. Let's have another intent. Let's create another intent, and then I'll be able to explain this point better, little better. Create another intent, click on this, and let's say another intent is called courses. Let me give it a description. Handling queries on courses. Okay. So user example, let's give some examples of this kind of query. Which courses do you offer? Say, what are the courses of study? What all subjects can I study? What all do you teach? What can I learn at your place? I am not adding those kind of things that can I study physics, that we will handle later on. Okay, now go to try it. Let Watson continue his learning. In the meantime, let's go to dialogue and add one more node. Add node to handle courses. Handle courses. Let the training get over. Let it complete the training. Otherwise, it's taking up my screen space. Okay, so I can close this part. Okay, if the assistant recognizes intent, but then intent courses, then assistant responds with, let's find the most suitable course for you. Okay, and now let's try. Okay, let's try now. What's the time? No, it can't handle. Now, which courses do you offer? Okay. Where are you located? Okay, I can guide you to my place. That is working. What can you teach? Let's find the most suitable course for you. Can you teach me physics, which we did not put as an example? Let's find the most suitable course for you. And there was one where I had given it a wrong training. Where are you located? No, which courses do you offer? I think this one. Huh. I had given it a wrong training earlier. Oh, that's okay. It has learned it by itself. Able to change. Yeah, that's somewhere I did a wrong pressing. Something, I'll have to see which question I did the wrong one. Okay, so right now what we have is, there is a welcome note, and let's modify this welcome note also. So far it is having only one sentence. Hello, I'm Raji, what can I do for you? Let's have variations. Hello. Good to see you. How can I help? Some more. Hi. Hi. How are you? Can I help? Okay. Now if I try it and I clear it, keep clearing it again and again, again and again. Every time it will give you different option. Hello, I'm Raji, what can I do for you? Clear it. Oh, this random thing. Seems it doesn't know how to use a random. So let me change that random. Okay, let me put it to, this was supposed to be sequential. Okay, sometimes, you know, technology behaves in a very funny manner. Let's try it once again. क्लियर? हेलो हेलो, ओके नाउ इट चेंज फाइनली. हेलो, गुड टू सी यू, हाउ कैन आई हेल्प? हेलो, आई एम राजीव, व्हाट कैन आई डू फॉर यू? हाय, हाउ आर यू, कैन आई हेल्प? हाय, हाउ आर यू, कैन आई हेल्प? हेलो, गुड टू सी यू, हाउ कैन आई हेल्प? सो यू सी, एवरी टाइम इट इज गिविंग ए रैंडम काइंड ऑफ रिस्पॉन्स विच यू कांट प्रिडिक्ट. इट्स नॉट द लाइक ए मशीन, इट इज रिपीटिंग दो सेम वर्ड्स अगेन एंड अगेन, अगेन एंड अगेन, अगेन एंड अगेन. Now quickly let's add some fine features so that you know thoda maza sa aa jaye ki bhai isko vastav mein kuch aata hai. Now so far it can catch the intention that whether you are looking for directions or you're looking for courses. Now let us teach it some values also, some specific numbers or say some words. Go to entities. No entity so far. The difference between intent and entity. Intent is a general intention to talk about a topic. Entity is a particular value. Say for example, in the course is physics, in the course is biology, in the course is chemistry. So it has a particular value. In computer programming, it is equal to, the double equal to. If it sees that value, so let's create an entity. Let's learn it through an example. Let's create an entity. Let's call it. Now entities are to be named with an at. So this at you can't remove because this is compulsory. So say science is one entity, and in science there are values. Say for example physics, and you can add synonym because someone might be saying physics as PHY. Press enter. Someone might be really bad in writing physics, might be writing it like this, or someone might be writing physics as physical sciences. Handle, we'll handle everything, whatever they say. Add value. Now let's add some more. Biology, and give it some synonyms that someone might call it bio, someone might call it life sciences, someone might call it biology, because we get all kinds of people, so let's handle them also. Add this value. Let's add one more, say chemistry, and some synonyms, chemical science. Even whether it is right or wrong doesn't matter, but if someone calls it like this, can I study about chemicals or something, add value. Every time you will have to go back to the dialogue and you will have to adjust your dialogue. Now courses. Now in courses we have taught it three values. Let's see. Assistant responds. Click on this customize and go down to multiple conditioned responses. Apply. Now if assistant recognizes courses, assistant responds, and now it has added those conditions. So first condition, if it sees this entity, it will tell you which entities you have. You need not write any code. Science, and the value is physics. Say physics. Just a minute. Physics is a good choice. Add response. Say entity, science, and say chemistry. So you are interested in chemicals. And if it sees entity in science is bio, no need to code. Biology is, say, life itself is, say, studying life itself. And now let's try it out. Now let's try it out. Let's try it out. Clear it. It will give you the welcome message. And now let's say, do you take tuitions for physics? We didn't teach it. We didn't teach it so much. Let's see how it handles. You see, physics is a good choice. The chatbot knows how to. Okay, two participants have raised hand. It will be much easier if you can put it in Q&A. Or else I can give you time to, let me stop sharing this thing. Okay, so Q&As are also there. Okay, course is offered. Will this session recording be emailed or shared? Yes. But the course I have already shared on anytimeteacher.com. I have already shared the course. All these things that I'm teaching you, that much is already there. Okay, and let me see who wants to actually speak. Narayani Patil, ma'am. Okay. Narayani, ma'am. Please unmute yourself to speak. Acha, I think you have already put your question in the chat. Okay, so we have been able to make a basic kind of chatbot. Now let's see how to share it with your friends. I said now that today's session is more of starting a basic chatbot. Now to close today's session, let me tell you how to share it with your friends that they can try out whatever you have done, or you can send the link to us and we can try out your chatbot. Say the basic functionalities. Let me share that part. So go to this left panel, go to an assistant. There is one assistant by default. I don't want to use that assistant. I want to create a new assistant. And I say my Semka assistant bot. Okay. And just say create assistant. Now, this bot doesn't have any skill so far. So say add dialog skill and choose which one. Say this is skill that we made earlier. Feed it, give it to this assistant. So now there is an assistant named my Semka assistant bot. It has one skill which is named my Semka chatbot, which we made earlier. And in this part, say here, if you click on it, it will give you API details. So I'll give you two ways out. See, if you click on this API details, just a minute. This top wala part. Okay. This API details, this URL and this API key, these are the two things which the, let me show it to you. This is my own chatbot. This is my anytimeteacher.com WP admin, means the what is behind the website. Now here I have an extension, a plugin, which is named Watson Assistant, free. You set it up. When you go to set it up, it asks you these details, assistant URL and the API key, which I have basically copied from here. Assistant URL and API key copied from here, and I have pasted it here. And the chatbot here starts functioning. So what I'll do is, just to show you that it is working, I will copy this assistant URL. And I will copy this API key. And save changes. I am not logged in into my, just a second. It will hardly take any time. When I logged out initially to show you all that, then at that time I logged out of my own site. It won't take much time. Okay. So this Watson assistant. Okay. But once again, I'll have to say copy assistant URL, paste it here, and API key copied and save changes. Now the chatbot that we were making, I was making in front of you, is on my website. You go to anytimeteacher.com, you go to anytimeteacher.com, and on the left side, you see this icon. If you click on it, click on this delete so that previous one goes off, clear messages. Now, do you see those messages have started coming? This you can try even on your mobile. Go to anytimeteacher.com and this thing, this icon will appear there. This is the chatbot that we made just now. You can try it out here. See, you clear message and you will get those messages that we were trying out. And now let's say all those questions, let's ask. How can I reach your place? Okay, I can guide you to my place. Do you see that? Do you teach physics? Physics is a good choice. I wish I study bio. Biology is studying life itself. Do you see the fun? See, we took more than half of the time in setting up our account and all those things. In no time, we have been able to set up a working chatbot. Now, suppose you do not have your WordPress website. Then how do you share it with your friends? Go back, click on the, come to this thing, My Samka Assistant Bot, and look at this thing, integrations, click on it. Integrations, lot of integrations, because different type of websites are there. WordPress is only one possibility. Add integration. And it will show you all the ways that you can integrate your chatbot with the, in your site. Now, out of this, I will suggest that you try only this one right now. Preview link. I'm clicking on this preview link, create a preview link. I'll modify it a little bit. My preview link from Samka. Create. And it creates a preview link. I'll show you because, okay, this entire link that it has created, I will post it in the, I'll have to stop sharing. I'll post it in the chat box, in your chat. Click on that, what I have posted in the chat, and a new window will open up in which you can try my chatbot. Likewise, you can copy this link and you can send it by WhatsApp or you can send it by mail, and people will be able to try out your chatbot. So two things we have tried to try out our chatbot. One, I have shown you right now on my site, anytimeteacher.com, the chatbot on my site is the one we made right now. And you know what all it can do. And even if it is little bit, but it can do it very faithfully and 24 hours, 7 days a week, 12 day, months a year, it can continue doing that. And second thing that I have shown how to share your chatbot is by sharing the preview link. This session was intentionally kept to simple, which is the best and free chatbot software that can use in higher education. That question is different from the session. Session is on making your own chatbot. So I pass this question. There is one person who has raised the hand. I think Narayani ma'am has forgotten to put the hand down. Okay, so I won't cross the line too much. I've already crossed the line. The recording might be available on YouTube. That ma'am will let you know where is the recording of the session today. The course is on anytimeteacher.com, and I shared with you where is that course. Out of you, all those who are interested in learning the complex features of this chatbot, we will have a follow-up session. Ma'am, I hand over the session back to you. Madhu ma'am, thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Dr. Tyagi. It was so interesting, but I know it will take time. It is just the practice, what we do, and then start creating. It was very interesting. And the learning will be on what, how much we put in the time and effort. Even yes. Ram Thakkar has also said that it was good presentation, and many more have said it is good presentation. So it was actually, it was a wonderful presentation. It's a new concept, not a new concept, but the learning is absolutely new. Thank you so much, Dr. Tyagi. Maybe you, if ma'am. We have one or two questions from our participants, if they can ask. Manas, can you please see that if anyone has anything to ask or share something? So many people, they are saying that they need to have this as on the YouTube. We will see how we put it. But maybe the next time, all of you, those who are attending, we will have one more session so that you, meanwhile, you create your own chat box and learn. And whatever problems you have, you can come back. And maybe the little higher end, Dr. Tyagi will, or the more complex things also, Dr. Tyagi, by the time, he will, in the next session, he will do it. So everyone, Sujata, everyone, they are saying that it was very interesting. Anything, any questions? Jwala has written, thank you so much for the, how can we use this feature, and so on and so forth. So many, many, everyone, I think, is appreciating Dr. Tyagi, this session. And we all from SEMCA, my colleagues, definitely we thank you. And we look forward to more such sessions.
Hello. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Raghavendra has a question. Yeah, Raghavendra, okay. Go ahead.
Yeah, sir. Yeah, Tyagi sir, it's a wonderful session. We have missed some of the part because we have lost the power connectivity. I mean, from a remote area, I was there in a, at least, means you can say it's a jungle. I am from a Navodaya teacher in Andhra Pradesh. I just have a good rapport with the SEMCA people because I met Sanjeev Mishra when he was a director, I think so, in the Delhi office. So I keep on observing all the details of the SEMCA activities day to day. And one more, my question is, because we have guided the chat box with the annotations what we have typed. So is there any complex, really artificial intelligence which we can indulge so that we need not give such kind of dialoguing and annotations to that so that it can automatically. So suppose if a student wanted to learn a particular concept, so if we ask a video, which I just wanted to go through that video, if the chat box is able to give you two or three alternative automatically, suppose if we suggest means we may suggest one or two links, but if there is any such kind of complex artificial intelligence which involves that, it will give a variety of learning content by videos or something else. Is there such kind of thing?
Yes. Initially, when we were looking at the catalog, one of them was IBM Discovery. Now, Discovery adds the search features, the power of search to your chatbot. So you will have to add that. I'll give you other examples so that you start understanding what I'm trying to say. See, for example, here we were typing our question and the answer was coming as a message. Suppose you just want to speak. So you will have to add, which was shown as free, speech to text feature to your chatbot. Now, suppose you want that the answer should be spoken to me the way Alexa was speaking. You will have to add text to speech feature to your chatbot. So there were 18 such services which IBM offers free, and which I showed you in the beginning that even though Watson Assistant was showing as the first product, that might be you are looking for this, you know, featured product. But still I showed you that how to go into various services, how to look for AI services. And there were 18 in that category, AI machine learning kind of, you know, those there in that category. And these were the services which I showed you. So you add these features to your chatbot. So then your chatbot can understand when you speak, it will be able to understand. whatever it want to say, it will be able to speak with a voice. And if you add discovery to it, it will be able to search and then give the answer. Now, okay. In search, you can give the chatbot your own set of documents. See, might be you are running a school and you learned it with difficulty how to run a school in remote areas. And you want that next person who takes your position should get this knowledge in the form of a chatbot. All those documents that you have made, you can upload. The chatbot will search through those documents and will give the answer. Those features can be added.
So one more. So when we can have the follow-up session?
See, follow-up session will depend on interest. Now, one of the things out of the whole good session that that actually I felt was lacking initially, and that's where I requested Madhu ma'am, allow me to wait for a while. Only eight attendees, and I could even see in the video that panelists were actually busy making those chatbots. So there were only around say 14-15 people who were actually making the chatbot with me. Now this, now at the end of the session, you can see why I was insisting on it. Without you doing it, there is no point of me speaking about it, putting a course over it. There is no point about it. It is a skill. You have to do it alongside.
Simultaneously, we need to do along with
it. So your follow-up session might be that they select some of you, and only for those selected people, they will have a session. So you should be able to impress Madhu ma'am and other people at SEMCA. Only then you will get a follow up session.
Okay, definitely. What should we do for impressing her? Definitely, we will do it.
I think she will get impressed only by your work.
Thank you so much, Raghavendra. Definitely, to all the colleagues who are attending this, make your chatbots. Try to make the chatbots. Then only we will learn where we are facing the difficulty. Once you are ready, let us know. You all have our email ID. You have Manas' phone number and everything. Just let us know. We will fix up a date maybe after 15 days and we will have another session. No problem.
Definitely. Okay? Thank you, madam.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah. Ma'am, can I ask a question?
Yeah, Ritu, go ahead.
Dr. Tyagi, thank you so much. It was a very enlightening session, and I really didn't know about this chatbot, so I learned a lot. I just wanted to ask you, is it possible to do this in a regional language?
I'm sorry, I typed the answer. See, initially, I'll show you that option. When you go to that chatbot, there were certain language options were there. But there you will find Arabic is there, Chinese is there, Spanish is there. Indian languages, you will find they are not there still. So regional, Indian regional languages is still not there. But then see, I showed you this thing earlier. Alexa, Hindi samajhte ho kya? Dekho, see, if you Alexa, which all languages do you understand? Are English? Okay. So right. they have reached Alexa. Thank you. Alexa has come up to Hindi level, and that is actually lot of training that has gone into it. But other chatbots, say, not able to reach up to that level. You know, there are in Hindi, there are so many dialects, so many variations from district to district, you know, the language changes. But I have seen it does not fail. You ask it in English or you ask it in Hindi, it understands and it responds accordingly. So Hindi is a maximum that you can hope for. Other regional languages, at least for very near future, I don't think it will be there.
Okay. Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you, ma'am.
Okay. Thank you, Ritu. And I think with this, we will end today's session. I know everyone is appreciating Dr. Tyagi's presentation. We from SEMCA and personally from my side, Dr. Tyagi, we really appreciate the session. And we look forward to once my colleagues, they are ready, all of them, those who are prepared, the chat box, we will definitely come back. we will definitely come back and we'll have another session.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you.
Hello, ma'am. Can I ask the question? One question, please.
Okay, last question, Narayani. Just go ahead.
Ma'am, I'm 11 and I love this session. So can we, can you just tell the name of the application that we used today?
Oh, did you miss the beginning part? Because we spent a lot of time.
I missed the beginning.
So you, will you please go through the course that I mentioned? I'll share with you the course details because there you will be able to see it on anytimeteacher.com. anytimeteacher.com, you go to, let it come, you go to the third menu item, other courses. There the first item is making chatbot using IBM Watson assistant. You will have to log in. In the top right corner there is login. Log in using any Gmail account. And here there will be a button coming in the beginning of the this class today, the session today. I did it in exactly the way that you were seeing it on your screens. So there is a button which comes here, take this course. And this course talks about all those things. So we used IBM services, IBM Watson services to make a chatbot.
Okay, so I love the session. It was really great. I knew about this session, but because of some problems, I had attended it at the last. So thank you so much for such wonderful session. I would like to have many more sessions like this from you, sir.
So
Narayani,
good to hear.
So what are you doing, Narayani?
Ma'am, I'm in 11. I'm 11 years old and I'm in fifth standard right now. So I heard about this session from my father. He shared the link and I joined a bit late because of others. I had other classes. So ma'am, I'm really sorry.
So I think if we should be motivated, an 11 year old girl, she is so much interested. And I think we all need to learn from Narayani. So big clap for Narayani. Narayani, thank you so much. And next time also, we will definitely invite you. And I'm sure you will make a small chatbot.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. So good. Thank you so much. So now we say bye-bye for the moment. And Dr. Tyagi, once again, thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Okay.
Thank you very much, Dr. Tyagi. Thank you very much.
Bye.